situation of the farm is on a slight height, and there's a little river running about maybe 200 yards from this farm. So we have to be very careful that there's no incidents of pollution, because water runs down the hill, and if anything gets into that water on the farm, it is inevitably going to end up in the water course. If it ends up in the water course, it's going to cause pollution. To prevent contamination of water courses in certain areas where the land around it is vulnerable, we do establish a buffer zone where we fence off a little area right beside a stream, just to make sure that cattle don't tramp the soil into the water. If soil goes into water, that takes the oxygen out of it, and it causes potential pollution, as well as eroding the banks of the stream. Certain fields and so on, cattle tend to go into the rivers for drink, so we establish water troughs for them to prevent them from tramping down into the water and fouling the water and leaving it contaminated.
Well, we're standing here in a shelter belt on the farm. What we're doing here is we're using the shelter belt for a number of different functions. So obviously one of the things is to keep the animals away from the water. It's a wet enough farm, it's on a north-facing slope, so a lot of water has to get off the farm.
We have a high rainfall in this area, so we have to be very careful with the land management. We don't want to see the land poached. So it's very important that we take the cattle off the land in the winter time, put them in sheds so that the land is not poached irreparably. In the summertime, the ground should be firm enough, but occasionally with recent weather trends, we have been getting very damp spells even in the middle of the summertime. The summer of 2012, for example, was very wet, and cattle had to be housed on numerous occasions just to try and prevent ground from being badly damaged, from being badly poached. Where ground is left brown over the winter, there's much more danger of silt being washed into the watercourse. Fields are all kept green all of the year here, so there's not a problem with silt being washed into the watercourse. With cattle, we tend to keep them fairly close to the gate. As long as the watercourse is nowhere near that particular area, that is fine. The area around the gate may be tramped a bit, but that's not as bad as trampling the whole field. With sheep, we move about the troughs because the damage is not so severe with their feet. If a field is really badly tramped with cattle, in other words, too high a density of stock in the field can get so badly tramped that it's actually a mass just of moving soil. And if it comes a big downpour of rain, that soil will end up in the river. The ground in this area was drained many years ago, and some of these drains now are being tramped in with the heavier machinery, compaction, and higher stocking density. So if there a wet area appears in a field, we have to go in with a digger and repair that. That prevents areas becoming waterlogged and allows the water to get away. If there's a damp area in a field and there's no natural outlet, we tend to fence that off, because those wet areas are very prone to support snails, which are involved in the whole liver fluke life cycle, and that leads to problems with both sheep and cattle having liver fluke in their livers. The livers are condemned and their performance is impaired. So we want to try and make sure any of those damp areas are fenced off if it's not possible to get the water away.